Mary Ann Hansen. I'm an extension plant pathologist with Virginia Cooperative Extension. And we're out here today on July 17th looking at a disease of tomatoes that a lot of gardeners complain about. So a lot of people will notice this problem in their tomatoes where they get leaf spotting, especially on the lower leaves, and those leaves turn brown, and that browning appears to move up the plant. That's typically the description you get. And these are symptoms of a disease called Septoria leaf spot, which is very common on tomatoes in Virginia. And we're out here today looking at my own tomato plant, which has been very neglected all summer. I've been just spending too much time in the lab. And so these plants have not been sprayed with a fungicide. They haven't been carefully staked or mulched or anything. And so they have a lot of Septoria leaf spot. So what you'll notice is in the lower canopy, you see some complete browning of the leaves. And those brown leaves earlier looked like this leaf that I have here, which shows some individual small, roughly circular leaf spots. And you can see a lot of those leaf spots on this leaf. You'll get more and more leaf spots that will coalesce and cause that whole leaf to turn brown. And then the spores that form on those leaf spots will splash to other leaves by rain or irrigation water and cause new infections. The fungi in general like a really humid environment, so that's why the disease tends to start out in the lower canopy where there's usually denser leaves and a more humid environment, and then move up from there. And the problem is that the disease can kill a lot of the leaves, so you've lost a lot of that carbohydrate source for the fruit, and that means that you get a lower yield of fruit. So it can be, even though the pathogen doesn't directly cause spots on the fruit, it can really lower the yield and affect the fruit. So it's definitely a disease you would want to control. Unfortunately, we don't have any good resistant varieties yet that are available. So you can buy tomato plants that are resistant to several other common diseases of tomato, but not to Septoria leaf spot. And there are breeders who are working on this. There are breeders at West Virginia University who have actually developed some plants that have less spotting than is typical of a susceptible variety, and they hope to commercialize these varieties eventually. But in the meantime, if you want to control this disease, you're going to have to use some other practices, for example, protectant fungicides, and you can get either synthetic or biological control fungicides that work pretty well for this disease, but you have to spray on a regular basis because these spores form and reform all summer long. And so you're getting splash of these spores to new leaf tissue, so you have to protect that new leaf tissue from infection. So a regular spray program will prevent the disease. Other things that are important to do are some cultural practices, like careful staking of the plants to provide good air circulation around the foliage. Remove that leaf debris at the end of the season because the fungus can overwinter on the leaf debris and then be a problem again next year. And then if you can, rotate your tomatoes to a different area of the garden next year, because I can tell you that this disease is pretty much a problem in tomatoes every year in Virginia.